Okay, so once you're inside Webflow, what you want to do is basically create a new site. Comes up with a name by default. I'm just going to call this one ABC Adobe Webflow to ABC. Okay, so I'm just going to select on the free template. So I'm going to select this template and then create a new site. And the site designer loads up pretty quickly. So you now get this sort of designer web, basically like an editing tool. So you've got different sections here. You get a header, navigational section, a hero section, a body section, a sort of services section, which basically you can simply just go in and edit and change if you're doing a just basic. Then what you've got on this right hand side here, you've got all these different elements, so you can add different sections and dividers, buttons, text, dynamic content, all these different things in here, which, you know, I'm not going to take you through. Then you've got the pages section, you've got home, you've got contact, so, and then you've got your collections in here. Collections is maybe a wee bit above my pay grade at the moment. So there's what we've got. Then what you've got, this you've got this button here which allows you to look at the preview. So you can look at the site here. You've got it here on a sort of desktop. You've got it here on a sort of tablet. Click on here. You've got it on landscaped phone. So you get a nice menu, dynamic menu here. Hamburger menu, sorry. Okay, without further ado, what I'm going to do is I'm just going to start from top to bottom, go through and just simply customize this template. So I'm just going to double click on here. Now this is it's got this navigational element here is in a, basically it's just using plain text. So if we kind of double click on here, we could change the text. So I want to delete that, and then what we've got here, we've got this brand link class. So what I want to do is I actually want to insert an image into that, so I'm just going to drop the image into there. If I do it properly, double click on there here and then go replace image, and I need to upload an image. Here's the client's logo here, and there we are there. And I know I've done that wrong. No, that worked cool. And then what we've got is we've got the dynamic menu, the navigation. So what I'm just going to do is I'm just going to click on here, and then I'm going to duplicate that, and I'm going to duplicate it again. I'm going to call this one here services. I'm going to call this case studies, and property cost auditors. We've got some text here. There we go. This text here is no win, no fee. What we do, there we go, we just use this text here rather than me making it up. Rates, relief, IP, recovery. Okay, so we've got some basic text here, and we'll just go down the bottom and change this thing here about PCA. We don't need this Webflow one in here. Sorry, Webflow, if you're looking. I can change this link here. Okay, and I'll just publish that. It does sort of auto save as you go along. Okay, so now what we're going to do is basically we're going to click on here, click on the hero section, and what we want to do is we want to go down and we want to change the background image. So we go down here, and what I'm going to do is I'm just going to delete here, and then click on here, goes add background image. So, and we're going to upload because we don't have one there. So let's look at one. And we'll just use this one here. So choose that there. Okay, so the image goes in here, and what we want to do is, at the moment it's within the container, what we want to do is we now want to kind of cover that image as so, and just get rid of there. And what I want to do is I want to get rid of this gradient filter. Okay, so now what we want to do is just change some of this colored text. So I'm going to change the button colour, the background, make it orange. And we could change that one there because it looks a bit dull against that. Okay, now what we've got is we've got the, if we click up here and we go to the menu, so we've got the navigational link, and what we want to do is I want to change. I'll make this one orange as well. There we go. It's changed to orange, and let's pump up the font size as so. And then what we've got as well is that we've got this like hover state. So if we make sure we're still selected on that item here, and we go to state, hover, and we want to change the hover color to whatever that gray was. I'm not sure if I've done that right. Here we have, because there's, you can see here, you get this effect when you, it's orange and then you hover over it. Okay, so you can see here that this one's here got two classes. It's got navigational link and it's got current. What we want to do is we're going to the other navigational items. And it's just got one class here of navigational link. So again, what we want to do is we want to change this one up to, and what happens is when we change one, it changes all. So we want to pump up the font size to 20, as so. And we want to change the colour to the orange as well. So they've all changed to orange. And then what we want to do is we want to get into the hover state. And you can see the hover state at the moment is blue. Okay, so now the hover state is now grey. We're going to the actual complete container. What you'll see here is you'll get this open menu, so you can see what the menu looks like. At the moment, it's on a drop down. What I'm going to do is just move this over to the right, which I sort of like, and you can then determine where and how you want the navigational, or the hamburger menu or the mobile menu to appear. So you can say, well, I want it to appear when people are on full screen. At the moment it's just set for tablet and below. You can change it to mobile below. And then ideally what you then want to do is basically kind of customize these colored backgrounds of the menu. The next thing what I'm going to do is I'm going to go down here and I'm just going to get rid of these images here, and then what I'm going to do is I want to insert a brand new image, so I'm just going to go there, and we're going to drop an image in there, and then what I'm going to do is just replace that with a new image. got some small images that I made earlier that I purchased elsewhere, so I'm going to pop that one in here. Okay, and if we just select on that image here, we just go back to the settings of it. What we're going to do is we'll give this a class. We're going to call this column image. And now what we can do is we can add a little bit of margin as so. And then what we can do is we can control paste Okay, so I'm just going down here and change different sort of elements. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to go into the other page. I'm going to go into the contact page, and we're going to go down here. Okay, so there's that. What I'm going to do up here now, just double click in here, and this is like a module. So it's not San Francisco. I'm just going to put Glasgow in here. Voila. We could change and style this button, and okay, so I'm back on the home page. So you can see here the different sections. If you click on the different sections and you've got the navigator open, you can jump to each section as so. So what I want to do now is basically style the mobile navigation background. So I select on an item in here, and I'm just going to select the navigational menu as so, and I'm going to go to mobile view, and then I'm going to go into the settings. And if we sort of scroll down in the settings here, you'll see the color there. The background was blue, so I want to change that color to my kind of dark brown, gray, whatever color it is. So I just want to change that color there. And let's have a look at it in the preview. There we go there. So it's not perfect, as I said, I'm no designer, but you can see how we've changed that. So again, for some reason I seem drawn towards publishing there. So once we've got that in this state, the next thing what we want to do is we want to export the code. So if this is our site, it's ready. So we click on export code, and it's going to export the HTML, the CSS, and all the images that go with the site. So we just go prepare full zip. Okay, so we now have our file, and what we now want to do is we want to go to our partner portal. I want to create a new site. I'm going to start from scratch, continue, we use the, we'll call this Webflow to ABC, United Kingdom Data Center, European Union, create trial site. And as that is preparing itself, there we go, it's going to be a blank site, we know that. What we'll want to do is we'll now want to okay, so now what we want to do is we now connect to the server. There we go, we're now connected to the server, and we want to go to where our file was. And you can see here what we've got is we've got two HTML pages that we created. We've got our JavaScript folder, we've got our images folder, and we've got our CSS folder. And simply all you need to do is then simply drag that across. And now we can go to the preview site there. And at the moment there, you can see here the address there, Webflow to ABC. So Platonic is basically set up there as just simply the old coming soon. And basically as all these files transfer, this should all be over. Now what we can do is we can actually go in to our admin area. And we're in our admin area, and we can go to our site manager and pages, and we'll see we've got the different pages that are there. So that was the original home page. This is the new one within which was created in Webflow. So just preview, and there we go. Here we've got our our home page, as so. We've got our about page, our contact page. Just go back there. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to simply delete this original page here, since we don't need that. And we're going to click on our index page here, and we're going to go actions, and we're going to set this as our start page. And we're just going to update that. So if we go to our new site there, there we go, we've now got a sort of, and you can see that it still needs a lot of work done to it. And we can see all that there. So the first thing that I'm going to do is basically sort of integrate the web form module into this. So I'm going to replace this with that. So you can see here, let me just change this site over to the modern WYSIWYG editor. New editor, just save that. We've now got our contact page, and you can see here we've got this form. So what we want to do is we want to first of all, and there's the code that's sort of come over, so you can have a good look through the code that's there. So what I want to do first of all is I want to create a web form. So I'm going to create a new form. So we're going to go new contact form, use a workflow, customer inquiry workflow, case, that's fine. We're not subscribing to secure zone. Okay, so we'll get first name, last name, email address, and we'll go company name, and we'll go a multi-line custom field, and that's fine. And now what we can do is I'm going to simply just insert this as a web form module and replace. So I'm just going to simply going to go down here. I'm going to I'm going to duplicate this page here first of all, save the draft. So it's, we're going to just simply take the form here and we're going to go to, we'll just put the form in here as just the we're not going to put it in as a module this time, we'll just put it straight in as the sort of HTML. Okay, so I'm just going to get rid of the title. There we go there, so we've managed to change the button, tar that up a bit. So if we just fold that in. Okay, we don't have a template there for our form submission. So if we just go back to the dashboard, we can now see that there have been a contact inquiry, which is now stored within the CRM, where we can find the person and we can do whatever we want to do with them. Okay, so really what we want to really do now is create a template. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to go to our copy contact, I'm just going to select all the code and we're going to go to template, add a template, and we'll just call this one default. And then so we're going to paste everything in there. We're just going to publish that. Obviously we now need to put a page content in there, so from contact us, down to submit. So what we need to do is we now need to strip out it'll be here, so so we can just delete that, and then what we need to do is we need to put in our page content tag. And let's go to our system email. We'll go to our web form confirmation page. page template. Okay, so let's go to our copy page again, and then let's just preview. So let's fill this out again and submit. And now what should happen is we get a proper layout. Okay, so obviously you need to have the correct layout for that. So that's just, as I said, that's just the very, very basics there of of a site. You know, we could start going through there and start changing, creating new templates. Sorry, we could start going through there and start using all the different modules. So, for example, we could create, let's go on to our page template as so. So, what we're going to do is we're going to go footer. Footer body. So that's this this little bit of text here. So we're going to call this one footer about page template. Come back to our template as so. So what we're going to do is basically just take this text as so, just copy it, and then we're going to go site module, insert content holder, and then just replace it as so. So we're going to update that. I'm going to go to our content holder, footer about, and we've got our basic text in there. And then you'll be able to see, if we're to preview our template, it really doesn't look any different. We've got the same text, but what that means is that the client can now go into the content holder as so, and they can work with that text. I can say just go, they can go like that, they can go about us, we can, it's dead easy for them to sort of highlight there. So if they wanted to insolvency practitioners, where they could then link that to sort of different page. I'll go to this page. So there's our original footer. So if we just refresh that there, we can now see that the client has then got that ability there to sort of manage that content themselves without really out knowing anything about the code. Again, we could do this here. We could have a navigational menu on the bottom here. Let me just, I'm going to make a little menu here, and I'm going to go call this one footer menu. And we're going to call this one link one, and the class, you can see, right, the class is footer link. Okay, so the class is footer link. So we just simply want to strip this out, and so, and replace it with our menu. So we look for site modules, menus, select menu, footer menu, see what it looks like. Simply insert the module as so, and then we're gonna update that, have a look. So there we go here, and we then, there's a class associated to each item. Sorry. So as I said, you would just simply work your way through. Let's change the name of those links to, it doesn't matter. We're not going to do that. So you'd simply just work your way through. So we've got this copyright here. So I'm going to copy that text. And again, I would probably make that a content holder. I'm going to call this one just like copyright. If I could spell it right properly, pump the text in there, and we're going to go to our page template default, and we're going to scroll right to the bottom where the copyright is here, and we're just going to replace that text with site modules content holder copyright as so. So again, that just gives the client the ability copyright, let's make that 2010 to 2016, and just so if we now sort of refresh the template we have, this should be sort of the page content holder should be in the middle. Hey, check it out. So now we've got a nice little template we can now apply when we want to create a new page. So we're going to go create a new page, and we're going to go add a page. We're going to use what's the default template, and we're going to call this one services. We're going to call this one about us, about PCA, and I'm just gonna take a bunch load of text. Whatever it is you're gonna put in there. Publish the page, and I'm going to preview the styles from the default style sheet. So there we go there. Okay, and it's not a perfect page, but again, it's just going to show you there that we've created this sort of basic page from that there. The next thing you would do there is obviously is on the menu. As I said, I'm not a designer, I'm not a developer. But that just should give you a basic overview. Okay, we've now got the Webflow site within the Business Catalyst content management system, and you can see here there's some things that, you know, I should have done in the background, it's not right. So if we get into the admin panel, you can see here when you get into the developer mode, you can open up the, there's a couple of CSS files. You can see here that the code's kind of pretty clean. There's not a lot of it. So if I actually scroll down to my sort of background, if I look at my button color, you can see here the background colors. It looks like it's something that I possibly need to change. I think that's the one there. So just go in there. Yeah, it's blue, so I need to change that. Copy it. I can now overwrite that, save, let's just refresh my site, there we go, we've now got the hover colours different, and we've got this area here. You notice here I put the three images in the same. Now what I want to do is I want these, I want this to be, you know, content manageable. I want, you know, the client to be able to, you know, change these as and when. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to turn these into a web app. Now a web app basically is a kind of custom front end and back end web tool. So basically the first step then is to look at the code that's there for this particular section. And you can see here, if we just scroll up here, we've got there's the section there. So basically what I've done is copied that code, and what I've done is I've kind of laid it out into what its three columns look like. And you can see here each column has a class, which, you know, looks a bit like bootstrap code. So what we're going to do is basically turn this into a web app. So the first step is what we do is if we go to our admin console, we'll go manage, and we'll go to web apps, and we're going to add a new web app, and we're going to call this home page content. And then we're going to go on to next. And now what we need to do is we need to create fields for these the things that we're going to change. So the first one would be it would be an image, and if we select on there, it's going to be a media, and we'll make it mandatory. And the next field that we need is we're going to call this the header. It's not header image. And that's just going to be plain text. Again, we'll make it mandatory. And the next one is going to be body copy, and that's really all we need. We can use the existing there. So now what we need to do is we now need to go to the layout, and the layout, if we're going to the list, we're going to use the list layout. What we're going to do is basically take this code here for one of the columns, and we're going to basically put it in here like so. And then what we're going to do is we're going to change over the fields. So we're going to take that there, and we're going to make this is going to be the image. And rates review is going to be the H3 header, and the paragraph text is going to be just the tag description. Okay, so we're going to save that. Now what we need to do is on our app we need to create our three items. So we're going to call the first one rates review. Select our image, what's that one there, and we're going to put in some text, PCA undertake rates reviews for business owners who may be overcharged by local councils. Just making the text up. So there we go there. And our header there will be rates review. We could have used just the item name, but I like the flexibility. Save that item. Go on to our next one, which was called rates relief. Okay, so there we are. So what we've now got is we've got this web app here with three items on it. Now what we need to do is we now need to basically replace that on the page so that the static content becomes dynamic content. So what we then do is we then scroll down and go into our code. And you can see our row here. So what we want to do is that's the code that we've been using. And we want to replace that. Okay, and so what we're going to do is we go to web apps, list of web app items, choose web apps, homepage content, and we want to list all the items. So, and then we just about insert, and then we update, and then if we go to our there we go, we now have our web app, which is now sort of content managed within the system. Now what we might want to do also is now add in we might want to add in a small button, a call to action button, or we might want to basically create a field there for the images to make them click through to a particular sort of URL. So what I'll do is let's create a small button. Okay, so we'll just basically put that back in again. So there we go, we've now got our links in there, and if you see the text there, it says learn more. So what we're going to do is we're going to change that there, and we're going to go and we're going to put in there button text. So. I'm going to save that, and then we're going to go back to our web app. We're just going to go to button link. What was it? Contact.html. This way, call us. I'm just going to put different ones in here. So we just go back here. And there we go here. So we've now got three different call to actions with different texts, and obviously goes through to the correct page. So as I said, we've got a nice little web app here that can be sort of content managed. And again, we could do the same with this one, we could do the same with that. We could, you know, that should have been applied to the template. So again, I hope that gives you a good insight into, you know, how you know, Business Catalyst can then, you know, provide some you know, client. You get what I'm saying is you get a great front end design, and then you get the ability to use the back end tools that Business Catalyst have.